Hello, everybody, and welcome back to The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. And today we're going to go ahead and get another greedier run out of the way. Good old Magdalene. We had to get her out of the way eventually. So I figured since, hey, she now holds a pill. Is it a full health pill? Speed up. Oh, nice. Oh, hey, that makes Maggie not terrible, kind of, a little bit. All right, cool. I can work with that. So Maggie is not exactly the greatest character. Her special ability that she starts off with, she heals herself. Other than that, she's slow, but I guess now that she starts off with a speed pill, then I guess she is just Isaac without the D6 now and an extra heart container. So the downside of playing as Maggie is no longer a downside. Anyway, EOC Mustafa. That's how we're gonna do the seeds from now on. You wanna play it? There you go. There it is. Join along with me as we go on a wild, wild adventure. And we're gonna go ahead and get greedier mode. Now I'm currently at PAX South as this video is actually going live, so I'm not actually able to check out the Enter the Gungeon. I do have like one or two recorded, but I'll be able to start bringing that back up as a daily series to go alongside our Isaac videos once I do get back from PAX. So expect that on Monday we should be seeing some Enter the Gungeon videos with the new supply drop update. Now the thing is that I've been kind of playing mostly I haven't really done too much streaming of these games, like the Isaac, the Gungeon series. So I think we'll be picking up kind of on the save file where I have most of the things unlocked for Enter the Gungeon. I don't know. I don't think starting a new save file would be that great, although I don't know. I only ended up giving it like 13 episodes, if I remember correctly. Like, we got through Enter the Gungeon real quick, and I didn't really give it, I guess, the run that it kind of deserved. I feel like I could have definitely, increased the length of that series. So I kind of want to redeem myself a little bit this time around with Enter the Gungeon. It's definitely a fun game, and now that there's an update for it, I see no reason to not play it, so. Be sure to keep an eye out for that on Monday. Should be nice. All right, so let's see what we got inside of here. Skullcap. So that's actually going to make me immune to explosions. So that's actually really, really nice because that makes the Ultra Greed fight almost impossible to lose. I say almost impossible. Don't worry, I can still do it. But the fact that I'm immune to explosions now makes it significantly easier. Also, both of our bosses were Gurglings. All right, I'm okay with this. It's not too bad. It's not the bosses that I'm looking for here, but we can kind of work through it. They kind of share the health pool, so it doesn't really matter who I'm attacking as long as we're slowly getting through them here. It doesn't really matter if we take too much damage because I can heal it. Okay. I do want to have a few less flies, though. As much as I love having flies all over the place, I'd like to limit the amount here of extra enemies I have to end up killing. There we go. Now we're down to two. Now we're down to one. Come over here. All right. Now, normally I would go for the Tarot Cloth for an item, but like I said, considering I'm now immune to explosions, I don't really have to worry too much about survivability. So I think we're going to focus primarily on... We're going to focus primarily on the damage aspect this time around, since I can be just a little bit riskier. And I kind of like that, you know? I can take a character that's kind of slow and steady and make it a little bit better. Now, I'm kind of curious. That pill that I got was actually a speed up. Is that always going to be a speed up? Because if so, that's actually a kind of a nice buff for her. Because that's one of the reasons that I never liked Maggie, is that she's ridiculously slow. Ow. Okay. What do we got inside of our devil deal? Absolutely nothing. Yes. All right, cool. Oh, no, the penny. when I shoot the fire so that I can get a penny, and then a penny drops and I don't actually get the penny. Feels bad, man. All right, let's move on to the next floor. Hopefully we can find some actual stats up. We did get a nice tears up from the pacifier, but I'm kind of hoping for a little bit more. So let's see what we have here. We're going to go ahead and buy that key so we can go inside of our item room here. What do we have? Blood rites, not really that great. I've got maxed out tier rate, so that's kind of nice. Go ahead and put one bomb there. I got a nickel from that, so that's not too bad. Half a heart. So I should be able to use... I didn't mean to pick up that heart. Does blood rites hurt the health first? I can't remember. Yeah, it does. So I can actually kind of use blood rites a little bit here and kind of, you know, just clear my way through it. So this blood rites might actually be a decent item. Obviously, keeping an eye out for Isaac's heart would be amazing. But yeah, blood rites could actually be kind of nice. I use it on when the room gets a little bit too full for my liking, and you know, I won't end up getting overwhelmed. So I think we'll actually hold on to this item. This is one of the few times where blood rites actually is a fairly decent item. Like right now. See? Too many enemies inside the room. I kind of want to get rid of them. Now I'm going to have to find some more red health before I can use the blood rites anymore, but you know, that gives you a general idea of what to kind of expect from this item. Now, if we, by some miracle, and I do mean some miracle, we've actually got Isaac's heart, I would be able to spam this item every single time, which would be amazing. All right. So we're not going to use blood rites here. I'm going to go ahead and just pick up my yum heart and get no charges from that. Right. Right. Mm-hmm. Yes. Of course. I don't want mom's shoe. I guess we're just going to have to fight our boss here with just the basic. Yeah, we're just going to have to fight with basic damage right now. I'm really hoping for some kind of stats up here in a little bit. Okay. Play it a little safe here. Things are getting a little, just a little too freaky right now for me. Just a little too freaky now. All right, let's see if we can't kill. There we go. Now we should be fine. I'm going to have to kill my Devil Deal bosses with like one heart, but that shouldn't be too bad. And Peeper in such a big room really shouldn't be that much of an issue. Kind of wish I didn't take so much damage there. Not just from the health standpoint, but from like the money. Ugh. There goes the other eye. Now the fun begins. There we go. Also, I don't know why, but I really do like these types of games, you know, Gungeon and Isaac, so it should be fun to bring in another series. And, you know, since I will be trying to, you know, work out a backlog here, we should hopefully not end up getting overwhelmed, because that's one thing. I made the mistake last time when I played these different games. I got super overwhelmed of what exactly I wanted to accomplish, and that was a mistake on my part, because you all ended up looking forward to these things, and it hurts me. It really does. And since we're just kind of giving an update here of things that are going to be happening while I'm at PAX, I'm also going to be working. I do want to get highlight reels going for the different stream highlights, but instead I'm going to focus primarily on at least one a month. At the end of the month, we'll, you know, go over all the stream highlights of that month. So go for one longer video rather than a bunch of smaller videos, at least for right now. Because I'm starting to like balance out the actual like schedule here. It's weird trying to actually put myself on a schedule, but I'm trying to balance it out so that way, you know, we don't end up disappointing people. Aww. I did so well without getting hit in that portion. Oh, well. Hopefully I don't get Krampus, because I'd like to not fight that with half a heart. Okay, cool. Thank you. All right, we're definitely going to take the Dark Matter, and we're going to take Maul the Void, because that's some extra damage. We only have one heart now. Not that great. Not that great at all. And there was a Tinted Rock there, but there's, I don't think I could have gotten a bomb there, so not that big a deal. Okay, so we're definitely going to want to check this out first.
Paralysis.
I didn't mean to buy that, but hey, it's there. It is what it is. All right. All the Void should help me clear through a bunch of the enemies, so we should be fine. I'm going to go ahead and take Anarchist Cookbook just so I don't accidentally fat finger. Just so I don't accidentally fat finger the... Okay, cool. Moldy Bread would give me some HP. I don't need that. We can put that down. PhD could be nice. I don't see anything else that I really want here. Okay. We're gonna buy the heart for safety. All right, there's our build for right now anyway. I don't remember if the Maul the Void spawns hearts. I don't think it does. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm right. I can't remember. I cannot remember if Maul the Void ends up spawning the health that I'm gonna want here. Yay! It does! Nice! Awesome! Excited about that. Well, cool. I can use this to end up spawning some health for myself. A little bit of a low chance. I'm going to hopefully need to find a little bit more luck up here before we can actually get that procking. We have a decent amount of damage. Like, our tier rate is really nice, and our damage is fairly decent. It just looks like it's not that great because the tier size is so small, but that's because Dark or Fear Shot kind of reduces the size of tiers. I don't know why, but it just does. All right. Well, didn't get anything there, so. Oh, God. The Fear Shot. I hate Fear Shot, man. Never been a fan of it. Close one. Ah! Oh, wait. Those don't... Wait. Wait a minute. Can the Ultra Greed hurt me in any way except for Brimstone? Also, I forgot. Like, I'm immune to Ick Bombs. I can just throw these down. He can't hurt me at all. Damn. That's kind of cool. Now I really need to just find some health. Well, that's really nice. I don't know how in the hell. I don't know how in the hell I managed to dodge that, but I'll take it. Aww. Yeah, I didn't think that the little spikes there were also explosive. I forgot about that. Okay, so yeah, the Ultra Greed cannot hurt me in any way. I am basically immortal. Oh, cool. Speed downpill. And are you a wizard? Oh, boy. Such good items. Yes. Well, I guess we'll go ahead and use the tower card and see what happens. Half a heart back. I'll take that. Let's go ahead. We'll save that. We don't necessarily need to buy the key right away. All right, let's move on to the next floor here. And let's make some magic happen on the womb. All right, we're looking for a little bit of health here. We've got a reroll here, so that's not too bad. We'll take this. Get a little bit of extra cash. What do we got inside of here? Need a bomb for that. Don't know if there was one for sale. There was one for sale, so we're gonna go ahead and bomb that. We're also gonna buy the key. Check this out. Robo baby. Stem cells. Ugh. Well, that's not very good. What do we got here? Justice.
Justice.
Awesome. Another key, another bomb. Pretty happy about that. We're gonna go ahead and reroll this because I don't want any of that garbage. The sack of sacks is always a good item. And I think I'll take the champion belt. Yeah, I think we'll go ahead and buy that item. Cool. And since we're immune to bombs, we can just throw all these down. And because of the batteries that we're going to be getting, we'll just throw down more bombs. This will be the Bomberman build. It actually would be kind of nice if we actually could get like Bomberman items. Like just some kind of synergy, like sad bombs. Just like any bomb synergy will work with this. Right. Hey, look at that, another battery. Sack of sacks, also known as like the breaking item. It gives you an infinite amount of batteries. Damn, there's still more rooms. Let's go ahead and tank all that. All right, let's go ahead and see what our bosses are. Not happy about that, but maybe we can have some fun here. There we go. There's the hearts that we want. Cool. I wanted to like get them all situated before I went for the quick kill there. That way I get them right as I split, and it gives me a pretty high chance of actually getting the dark art. Hey buddy, you gonna attack? You just gonna, okay, bye, later. See you later, buddy. Go ahead and grab this battery. I really need to find like a decent spacebar item. Six Lokis, huh? Now I definitely have plenty of keys. Well, that's kind of cool. Don't need to buy any more of those. Kind of want to like get, there we go. Like a little bit of a double tap going there. There we go. Hit as many with that ring as possible. I think we're down to, yeah, we're down to three now, so. Now we're down to, oh, no. I guess we had one more. How many are left? Okay, so yeah, there was three left. Alright. Later, buddy. Let's go see what this devil deal has for me. Hopefully something nice. Empty vessel would be nice. That'll give me two dark hearts. That'll give me more hearts than I lost. And if I can get rid of these, the rest of these heart containers, that'll give me sometimes, you know, pseudo immortality as well as some flying, although that's not that important. We're gonna definitely take the champion's belt here, and we're gonna take the black candle. Oh, I would love the void, but unfortunately I can't. Tinted Raka. There we go. Got plenty of health. Now let's go see what is on our next floor. Good old Sheol. So after this, I think we only have like what, two more characters that we actually need to go for. Little horn. Cool. That's gonna give me the random insta kill. And safety cap. I think little horn gives me the potential insta kill. Or maybe it's a different item. We'll see. Do I actually want to bring this all the way over there? No, I don't really care. But I will bring it over to these guys. They can potentially, there we go, give me some money. There we go. So yeah, we're looking for a spacebar item here, which, eh. I don't think we're going to be finding too many of. There you go. Anarchist cookbook, baby. That's not too bad. What we need to do is find like a little bit of luck up so we can actually get like these effects going. Oh well. We got a little bit of luck up. Usually like greedier mode runs, it doesn't really matter if you get luck up or not, but eh. Wait. Oh. I was like, how'd that hurt me? Oh right. Invisible dude. There's no way that bomb should have hurt me. Was that a bomb? Dang. Already got our bosses out of the way. Or most of our rooms out of the way. Not bad. Move on to the bosses here. What do we got? Ragman. Some more hearts for me. I can keep just going to town. There we go. I don't know what you want me to do with all these keys, but thank you. I appreciate it nonetheless. One makes you larger. That's fine. We'll hold on to that. I have so much money and nothing to spend it on. Feels bad, man. Okay. Now we just got the double deal boss. Let's go ahead and knock that one out. I'm refraining from like ask. Usually I end up asking questions and things like that because I like to hear the response to stuff, but I'm not going to see anyone's response for like 4 days. All right, we're going to go ahead and take Gimpy since I'm just kind of tanking health and throwing it away anyway. We'll go ahead and buy a soul heart for some safety. You know, let's go with 2 soul hearts. Let's grab 2 soul hearts. And what's our last one? Another strength card. Aww. Should have held on to that. Or should have used it in the last room. Oh, well. It's not that big a deal. We'll use a strength card for these rooms. So we do have a reroll here. Let's go ahead and just throw down the Anarchist Cookbook. Hopefully it'll do absolutely nothing. Awesome. Chaos. You know I got to go with chaos. These bombs are useless. Oh god. Help! So much damage being tanked. Help. There's so much shit on the floor. What's even going on? Hey, another strength card. Sure, why not? Make me bigger. I like this build so far. It's run into everything. Does not give a fuck. Just run into it. All right. But we have a lot of health on the ground, so we can just kind of keep ramming our face into everything. Yeah, we've got a ton of health on the ground. And since we have all these special cards going right now, there's no reason to not kill my bosses. Oh, the double tap. There we go. All right, let's grab some of our health here. There we go. And back to killing. So it'll be smart for us to actually just like keep tanking health right now so that Gimpy might spawn some more soul hearts. All right. Hearts, 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 hearts. Hearts, hearts, hearts. What do we got? Blue map. Nice. No. Come on, man. I want to blow these things up. I want to blow those up, man. All right, do something in here. Do something cool. Nothing. All right. Incubus is always nice. I like Incubus. There's nothing else I can spend keys on or money on. So that's a little unfortunate. Guess we'll take the devil card with us. I should check the curse room out real fast. Yeah, sure, why not? Well, unfortunately, I couldn't actually proc the empty vessel. I mean, I could have, but it's whatever. It's not like it's gonna be that big a deal. We should be able to be just fine with this. I mean, with the double shot effect that we currently have, this is nice. Also, I like the duct tape add-on that we ended up putting on, because that just, like, that makes all of the followers just literally just stick to us. That's actually really, really nice. Go ahead and pop the double guard for a little bit of extra damage. And let the DPS rain down on him. Did I just fear a heart? I did. Oh. That's kind of cool. Well, need to be a little careful here, because I'm not going to be able to tank away on this. Not going to be able to tank away until after he gets into his, like, ultra greed phase. And then once we're at that point, then we're able to just not give a fuck. We can just go. We can just do it. I gotta remember, I still have the Maul of the Void effect, so I can attempt to spawn some more health for me. So we should actually let those, like, should let those keys definitely go through there. No, my extra health. Hey, extra health. What have you done with it? Okay. Let's stop tanking so much damage now. Let's stop doing that. Okay. Still gonna try our best here to, like, spawn some extra health in. I need to make sure I'm actually killing those hearts. Like, when they actually drop down. So I guess these things count as, like, explosive or something, because they're supposed to, I believe they're supposed to do contact damage. They're not doing any contact damage anymore. So, that's kind of neat. I know there's a heart in you somewhere. Hey, there's the money. There we go. That should be enough. To carry me to the end here. Oh, maybe I was crazy. Oh, well. Come on. No. 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 No more health. You're done healing for right now. You've had plenty, alright? Just gonna tank some health. There we go. Okay. Now begins the fun part. As long as we don't walk into them three times, we should be fine here. So, nothing should be able to hurt me. Nope, nothing can hurt me. Alright, cool. We're good. Barring me running directly into him or getting hit with brimstone, I'm immortal. How to completely trivialize the last section of the fight. It's like, there's nothing left for me to do. I just kind of wait until he dies. This is beautiful. This is beautiful right here. This is like payback for all of the shit that I have to deal with every single run. And all of his bullshit attacks. This right here is payback. I'm surprised that they would... Okay. Now, here's what boggles my mind and what makes me so confused, okay? So they add in armor. because I don't want people to get, you know, stupidly overpowered and break the boss in 2 seconds. But then you have items like one singular item. It's not even like a synergy. It's just one singular item makes you completely invulnerable to every single attack. Okay, except for the brimstone. But like his smash, his shots, the bombs he puts down, the little aerial effect, the spikes, everything is completely negated by one item. And if you get that one item, then hey, you're solid, dude. You don't have to worry about anything else, which is why I don't understand armor as a mechanic, because it feels like it kind of, it fails the whole purpose, like that it's trying to, like, the whole purpose of armor, I thought, was to prevent runs like these. And now you've got this. I don't know. Maybe I'm just crazy, man. I'll just shut up, man. I clearly don't know what I'm talking about. Oh, well. Anyway, that's the run, everybody. Thank you so very much for watching. Glyph of Balance has now appeared inside of the basement. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will see you all in the next video. Like I said, this is going up this backpack south, so if you happen to be in the San Antonio area, check my Twitter, say hi, and I will see you all in the next one, everybody. Later.